Welcome back to another API tutorial on getting financial data for free. Bloomberg is extremely expensive and this is my effort to help you guys get as much financial data as possible for free. Watch this video till the end and there is a beautiful gift for all my lovely subscribers. What is up everybody, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. Today I'm going to talk about one of the most used and free financial data provider, 12data, and we'll learn how to use 12data API directly in Python. In the last two videos I talked about AlphaVantage API and IEX Cloud API. If you want to learn more, you can click on this I button. And just to remind you that these two are also free financial data providers. The 12data API provides data related to stocks, Forex, and cryptocurrencies, very similar to AlphaVantage and IEX Cloud APIs. But the 12data API also provides 100 plus technical indicators data. Just to remind you, AlphaVantage does provide around 50 technical indicators data and IEX Cloud does not provide any data related to technical indicators. Also, for time series, there are several time frames available on 12data, ranging from as low as 1 minute to 1 month. Now let's see how to use 12data API directly in Python. For this, what you need to do is first get a free API key by clicking on the link which is mentioned in the description box. You'll have to make an account. You can make it by clicking on sign up and then this window will open. Just copy this API and store it somewhere. There is a 12data library available which you can install by writing pip install 12data, but I don't recommend it because sometimes it gives an error. So what we'll be doing here is we will be extracting information from URL. If you remember in IEX Cloud also we did the same. So if you remember my IEX Cloud API video, we'll be importing requests here as well in order to get information from a URL. And then this is my API key that I'll be using. I will disable this API after recording this video because I don't want you to use my API. Just get your own API by following the steps I mentioned. Now let's check out the API documentation of 12data. The link is in the description box. You can see that on left hand side, the 12data API provides information related to the time series, information related to stocks, forex, cryptocurrencies, ETFs, indices, and technical indicators, etc. By clicking on stocks, we can just scroll down a bit and get this URL, which is important, and that we'll be using this URL to extract this the information. Let's paste this URL here. So it will be getting information from the 12data.com API, website. And it's a time series data, symbol is equal to MSFT, interval is 1 day, output size is 12, and API is demo. Let me just do one thing is provide a F string here, change this to API key. Also what we can do here is provide ticker is equal to say MSFT and interval is equal to say 1 day. Let me just change this ticker and this one to interval. So now this link is more user friendly, I would say, and then we'll be using this .get request in order to get information in JSON format. Let's see what is the data. The data is actually I don't require meta, I just need values here. This is in a dictionary format because you know JSON provides data in dictionary format. So what we can do here is let's just import pandas library, import pandas as pd data one pd dot data frame. Perfect, so we have got the data in the data frame format. Let me just copy and paste this here and this one here. Now let's see what inputs we can provide in this URL. On checking on the API documentation, we can see that the inputs can be actually symbol is required, interval is required, exchange is optional, country, type, output size, format, API key is important, advanced, order is important if I want data in ascending format or descending format. The default is descending format. Okay, and then start and end date. This is an important parameter, very important parameter, I would say. So just after the symbol and time zone, which we don't require, we need to provide end, start date, and then end it. Just after this ticker, let me just put it like this, and we can delete this time parameter. And you can easily put this, you can easily provide a variable here and then put it in the string format to mention the start and the end date. If I do it like this, then I should get the data of, let me just change this date to 2020 start date 0101 and then 2020 0110. Perfect. So I've got the data from the 1st of January to the 10th of January. Now let's get the Forex data. If you go to API documentation and click on Forex, on right hand side you can see that symbol is equal to foreign exchange and all other parameters are exactly the same. So what we need to do here is just provide foreign exchange at the place of ticker, and if you run this cell, then you'll get the foreign exchange data of the mention, like between the mentioned dates. Now my most favorite cryptocurrency data. If you click on cryptocurrency here, again it's exactly the same. We just need to provide symbol is equal to the cryptocurrency exchange and all other parameters are exactly the same. So I can just provide ticker is equal to BTC/USD and I can see that the data that I've got is this one. And similarly for ETFs and indices data also, what we need to do is we just need to provide the ticker here. IXIC represents NASDAQ and SPX represents S&P 500. Now before moving to the technical indicators, mention in the comment box which topic you want me to make my next video on, and I'll be considering the comment with the highest number of likes. Now let's check out how to get the technical indicators data. Checking out the API documentation, you can click on the left hand side technical indicators and let's see how to get the B bands, which is Bollinger Bands. Let's scroll down a bit and you will get the URL which is useful to extract information of Bollinger Bands, and the URL is exactly the same except B bands, which is present where it was time series in the last URL. So what I will be doing here is, let me just copy this entire code and paste it here and then change it to B bands, or actually I would introduce another parameter which is technical and then B bands. Let me just change it to technical, and if I run this code, I will get the Bollinger Bands. We can also get the open, close and a low high price. So let me just go to the end and write it like this. Let me just provide and include OHLC is equal to true. And if I run this code, I will get the B bands with the open, high, low, close and volume data. If you're interested in any other technical indicator, what we need to do is we just need to copy say this beta on the place of technical and just write beta here to get the statistic beta function here. So we have a column called beta. Now you can see that it's fairly easy to use the 12data API, but it can be fairly seen that it requires a lot of work if you want to work on the different type of inputs to modify the URL. So in order to help you, and this is the gift to all my subscribers, I have made a code already, and what you need to do here is run this code and it will ask some information, say time series or technical indicator. I'm interested in time series data, enter, and then ticker. I can provide all these types of tickers, and let me just see Tesla. I'm interested in say 45 minute interval in descending order and 2020 01 01 to 2020 01 10, and you can see that the data of Tesla 45 minutes interval is now on the screen. You can also, let's go to check any other type of data, say time series, and then I'm interested in say index data, SPX data. So I'll just copy this and paste it here. I'm interested in say 1 day data, and in this case in ascending from 2020 01 01 2020 01 10, and you'll see that the S&P 500 data from the 1st of January to 10th of January is available. If you want to get the technical indicators data, you need to write here technical indicator. From this list of technical indicators, you'll have to write exactly as mentioned in order to get the right data, otherwise it will be an error. So I'm interested in say EMA, so I'll just copy and paste it like this, and the type of data, say Apple, 45 minutes descending order 2020 01 01 and then 2020 0110. So this data of 45 minutes interval is available and with EMA technical indicator. So it can be seen that it's very user friendly code that I've made for you. This code will be available on my Google Drive for my new viewers. You can get a free access of my Google Drive by subscribing to my YouTube channel and then clicking on access to my Google Drive button, and then just provide some basic details, and I'll be using this email address in order to give you access of my personal Google Drive. And this service is only available for my subscribers. If you like my work, then you can support me by buying me a coffee. The link is in the description box. Please justify my hard work by liking this video and sharing with your friends. Also subscribe to this YouTube channel if you don't want to miss out my future videos. Something great is coming in my upcoming video. Also mention in the comment box the topic that you want me to cover in my future videos, and get a free access of my Google Drive by following the steps that I mentioned. Thank you so much. See you in my next video.